Hello and welcome to this video talking about power amplifier measurement with DPD using Keysight's test software called PathWave X-series measurement applications. Power amplifier or PA is core component in wireless communication devices such as mobile phone and base stations. Many PAs are designed to be used with DPD, so it's important to measure PA performance on the DPD enabled. Before the demonstration, let's take an overview of PA tests and DPD. When we talk about the PA, there's always a thing about distortions. PA nonlinearity causes impairments such as gain compression or third-order distortion, especially when power gets high. Those impairments directly impact to the key performance metrics such as EVM or ACPR. When power level is relatively low, PA mostly operates in linear function. EVM and ACPR are pretty good with almost no visible problems. As power gets higher, the spectral regrowth in adjacent channels degrades ACPR dynamic range, in this example by 18 dB. Also, the gain compression causes constellation points spreading and EVM gets far worse. Those are the impacts of PA's distortions due to nonlinearity. If you enable DPD while maintaining same power level, you can see ACPR and EVM are significantly improved and it's a lot closer to the linear operation. So, how does DPD do its trick? You can think about PA input and output power relationship. When PA is perfectly linear, you can expect a constant gain across all power ranges all the way to the top. If we plot XY graph, with input and output power, the slope represents PA gain. If PA is linear, the graph is a straight line like this. In reality, however, PA is a nonlinear device. When signal goes through PA, the gain cannot sustain, especially in higher power region. In upright area in the graph, the line goes down compared to the straight line. This is called as gain compression. If we have knowledge of the nonlinear characteristics of PA, we can increase input power level before it goes into PA to compensate gain compression. As a result, the PA output is linear again, at least in theory. This is very basic concept of pre-distortion. When this power pre-adjustment is done digitally in baseband, this is called as digital pre-distortion or DPD. N9055EM0E is an X-app application to characterize power amplifier with digital pre-distortion applied in RF and millimeter wave with simple and integrated user interface. It utilizes smart link for automated SG closed loop control to support several functions such as download signal studio waveforms or user-defined waveforms, extract and transfer DPD models, config frequency and power level, power servo to auto-adjust PA output power. For DPD models, it supports memoryless model like lookup table and memory models such as memory polynomial and Ventura series. It supports several measurements at the same time such as AMAM, AMPM, ACP, Delta EVM, Demod EVM like 5G new radio or Wi-Fi 6 and 7. EVM vs power, dynamic EVM and DPD iteration measurement. There are two main PA test solutions based on N9055 X-app application. The first one is the signal generator plus signal analyzer. This hardware SA models includes UXA, PXA and MXA. SG models includes VXG and MXG listed here. The second one is VXT PXIe transceiver solution, which integrates VXG and VSA in PXIe module internally. There are several VXT PXIe transceiver models supplied for you to meet your different test requirements. Now, let's look at the first solution, signal generator plus signal analyzer. As we can see, LAN connection is between SA and SG for trigger and reference use. N9055EM0E X-apps PA application is running on signal analyzer as primary model to control signal generator. There are two working modes here, The first one is called generator. In this mode, SA extracts DPD model, then transfer model to SG. SG applies the pre-distortion to the waveform. This mode is faster with smaller data size because it only transfers model. Another working mode is called pre-distorted waveform. In this working mode, SA extracts DPD model and generates the pre-distorted waveform, then transfer this pre-distorted waveform to SG to play. This working mode is slower than the generator mode because it transfers the pre-distorted waveform between SA and SG. For more details, you can check out the demo video in this YouTube channel. The link is in the description box. Another solution is based on the VXT PXIe transceiver. It integrates the vector signal generator and the vector signal analyzer in PXIe module, so no LAN connection is needed here. It uses internal trigger and reference. Meanwhile, it supports auto-ranging in adjusting attenuation. This solution for PA test is much more faster compared to using signal generator plus signal analyzer because it does no need to transfer DPD model or pre-distorted waveform between SA and SG. For more information of this solution, please check out demo video in this YouTube channel, the link in the description box as well. To learn more and to download a free trial, visit us at this website.